music for taking a walk. Excellent, thank you. Well, today is going to be a first for me. I was doing some prep for my sermon this morning and came across a sermon that just said everything right. I added a couple things here and there, but for the most part, this sermon is from the Reverend Eric Carswell, and he gave this sermon in Bernalillo. And I just, the title of it is The Key to Feeling Grateful. Have you ever noticed that some people seem to recognize more things to be grateful for in their lives than others? This is not primarily caused by having more good events actually occurring for them. If you remember the story of the 10 lepers being healed by the Lord, the same miracle occurred for all of them, but only one returned to thank him. The other 9 must have noticed the miracle of their healing, but what was going on in their minds that they didn't return to Jesus and thank him? A person's thankfulness depends significantly on their state of mind. For example, 4 people might receive exactly the same gift. One could be too busy focusing on something else to even notice. A second could be so frustrated and angry that he already received the gift. A third might feel discouraged or depressed because he is so needy. But the 4th could feel a deep sense of gratitude. The gift might be the same, but the reactions are quite different. We are not told in the Bible story what was going on in the minds of the 9 lepers who were healed but did not return to the Lord. Perhaps they were so caught up in the need to show themselves to the priest that nothing entered their minds. Perhaps they were so focused on the next thing that they did not make time to return to the Lord. Only one, a Samaritan, returned to Jesus, loudly glorifying God and falling in humble acknowledgement at his feet. We are not told in the story, but perhaps something in that Samaritan's background made him less likely to take a miracle for granted and to respond with a deep gratitude for his healing. Like the Samaritan, we should show gratitude to the Lord for all he does for us. In our teachings from the Heavenly Doctrine for the New Church, it says, "The Lord does demand humility, worship, thanksgiving, and much else. But the Lord does not demand those things for his own sake. Rather, they are required for a person's own sake. For if someone possesses humility, he is able to accept good from the Lord." We do need to feel grateful, not for the Lord's sake, but for our own. But what if we don't feel grateful? Can we make ourselves feel grateful? Not really. We have control, to an extent, over our thoughts. We can control our actions. But a lot of times we can't directly control our feelings. Just as we cannot successfully make ourselves loving, feel loving when we don't feel it. So we can't make ourselves feel grateful if we don't feel it. It's a process. Most likely, the last time you may have felt grateful was because you felt cared for. Someone went out of their way to do something for you. Do we feel well cared for by the Lord? We all have times when we do not feel grateful to the Lord, and that's usually our state of mind. Yet we shouldn't dwell on that lack of thankfulness. What we can do is think about the Lord's care, perhaps reflecting on Him as our shepherd, as our carer, as our Heavenly Father, as a parent. And we can make time for those acts of worship that express thanks, such as prayer. So even if we do not feel thankful, we can act in thankful ways. We can attend church, pray, and we can share our blessings. So this key to feeling grateful is seeing things to be grateful for. Most of the time, we do not consciously see what the Lord is doing for us as it is happening. Think about that for a minute. It is essential for our freedom that we do not see His work too clearly. Yet the Lord works in more ways than we can possibly think of, from the biggest events in our life to the tiniest moments. We know that one of the ways that He works is by means of other people, people who can express something of His love and care. The Lord can touch our lives with some of His greatest blessings by the people around us. And when that happens, somehow we do not see these gifts from the Lord. We miss the caring and efforts. We miss seeing things that could arouse a sense of gratitude in us. Why don't we see all the good things that are happening around us? One reason is that our minds focus on things that are directly related to what we love. When we do not care about something, we pay very little attention to it. This is why it is important to keep our loves in check. What do we love? What is that important thing to us? It's interesting that when the angels look at other people, they scarcely see any evil in them, but instead focus on what is good and true. They even work to put a good interpretation on what is bad. The opposite is true of evil spirits, who tend to see nothing but the evil in others. And if they see anything good, they perceive it as nothing or make it a bad thing. So we can't assume the outlook of the angels. There are parts of us that may stand in the way of seeing what is good in those around us. But if we want to make progress, we can recognize the thoughts of contempt that we have for others. We can recognize when we are dismissing their efforts. We can recognize that we may actually spend our effort looking at the evil than looking at the good. Again, this is a process, and we need to work at fighting off those self-centered parts of our thinking. The more we believe, we will be able to see good things happening around us, and we will see other people doing loving things. We will see them supporting things that we believe are important. We will begin to see all the good that is going on in the world. And this will not be a shallow effort to look through rose-colored glasses. Have you heard the phrase, fake it till you make it? It's along those lines. It will change from that habit of saying, oh, isn't that nice about everything? And you'll begin to really see it. The Lord does ask us to act in a thankful way, even when we do not feel thankful. He does this to encourage us to work toward a state of mind in which gratitude comes easy. Each of us can prepare to feel truly thankful by working to see good things in those around us. We can work to rid our minds of thoughts that tend to diminish the value of other people's work. We can work to focus on what are truly the most important things in our lives. This is the labor of a lifetime. And as we make progress, we will more and more enter a state like the leper who returned to thank the Lord. Then our thankful actions and words will more and more come to be the true expression of a thankful heart. Amen.